Hello students, we are going to deal with the subject network analysis. What do you mean by a network? A network is an interconnection, right? We already know, we say cell phone towers, cell phone network, right? What does all that mean? It means it's all an interconnected system. Now, whenever we have a connected way, in an electrical terminology, we are going to call it a circuit. A circuit is nothing but any closed path. Now, we will have different kinds of elements in a circuit. We have passive elements as well as active elements. These are the basics which students would have studied in physics in the very first year of engineering. If you brush up those basics, you would recollect that we have seen something called active elements and passive elements. What do you mean by the term active? Active means something, some activity that is taking place, right? So in that sense, you can easily remember active elements are the sources. What do sources do? They supply voltage or current. So I have two types of sources, voltage and current. What are my passive elements? Generally, the term passive means to do nothing, to simply be a participant. Isn't it? That's why we say don't be a passive observer in the audience. Go out onto the stage and do something. So passive is generally to do nothing. In that context, you can easily remember passive elements are resistor, inductor, and capacitor. These are the major passive elements we are going to deal with in circuit analysis. So whatever I've drawn here is a sample, simple circuit. It's a sample circuit. It's a simple circuit. And I've just given you the different types of elements. So I have used a resistor and I have drawn a simple electrical circuit. Now when I draw this, it's not complete because current will definitely flow through any closed path. We already know that current will only flow through closed path. It cannot flow through an open circuit. So here we have a short circuit condition. We have a closed path. So current will flow through it. We have to assume the direction of current always in order to analyze any circuit. Now in network analysis, we are going to deal with analyzing different kinds of circuits using passive elements that we have. A circuit may simply have an R, or it may have more than a single resistor, or it may have a combination of R and L, or there could be all three passive elements in the same circuit. Or we could also have, say for example, a current source like this in series with a resistor, an inductor, and a capacitor. And we may have to analyze the behavior of this circuit when a current of say 5 amps is applied. So we will be dealing with such analysis. What is the need for us to analyze these circuits? In real life, whatever we see in our real lives, say for example, fans or pumps or as simple as mobile chargers, whatever we have, everything has circuits within them. Only when such elements are connected together, we get the output and we are using that output to feed the loads. So whatever circuits we have within these need to be analyzed before they are actually put into practice. That's why we actually need to analyze a simple model before putting it into implementation. So we would consider models like whatever is given here. This is one such model. This is another model. So in this model, we have LNC as well. And here we have a simple resistor. Like that, we have n number of networks which we are going to analyze. So this is just an introduction about network analysis. We'll see more about this and the different tools used to analyze such circuits in the upcoming videos. Please do subscribe to our channel to be updated on this subject. Not only this, but we would be dealing with various other engineering subjects and also communication skills. Thank you.